Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 4, lesson number 15. The topic it is fishing. I'm your tutor, Lucy Modoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to look at the fishing grounds that are found in Africa and those that are found in East Africa. We start by going through the fishing in East Africa countries, which is also in Africa. We have the fresh water, which is also the inland fishing grounds that are found in East Africa. We are going to look at them. And also, we have the marine fishing grounds that are found in East Africa countries. Now, when we talk about the in East Africa, we have the freshwater fisheries that are more developed compared to the marine fishing grounds. And we have to look at the reason why we have the freshwater fisheries being more developed compared to the marine fishing grounds. Let us look at the factors that have led to the freshwater fisheries developed in East Africa. The reason as to why we have that freshwater fisheries being developed than the marine. One point, or the first point, there are more inland fishing grounds compared to the marine fishing grounds. The only marine, or the only sea, ocean, that we can have as the fishing ground, it is only the Indian Ocean. But when we talk about the inland fishing grounds, we have a number of them. We have Malawi, we have Kyoga, we have Arubat, we also have Lake Victoria, which is the leading producer or leading fishing ground that we have in Africa. Number two, we have small and narrow continental shelf of about 6 kilometers, limiting plankton's growth. This is the reason as to why marine is not developed in East Africa, since the continental shelf, it is narrow and also it is small. The third one, we also have the inadequate capital for buying modern marine fishing equipment. This is the reason as to why we cannot go to the deep waters to do the fishing. Yet, we have the water bodies that are found there, and they are fish. So, we lack the capital. Number four, we have the regular coastlines with a few indentures or inlets for the breeding and development of the fishing ports. So, that is also another limit that hinders the marine fishing. And number five, we have the warm coastal waters that limit fish varieties. Remember we said that for the fishing to do well or for the fishing to develop, we must have that cont ocean current, and also we must also have them converging, the warm and the cold ocean current. But now in Africa, in East Africa, it is washed by the warm ocean currents. And number six, we have the low demand for marine fish species compared to the freshwater fish. You get that the people who live in East Africa, they like like the variety that comes from the freshwater waters than those that come from the ocean. So those are the factors that have hindered the marine fishing, and those are the factors that have favored the start, the development of freshwater fisheries in East Africa. Let us go to the specific countries. Each country, we look at the Kenya, then we go to the Uganda. The major inland fishing grounds that are found in Kenya, remember you have said the fresh fisheries are the ones that is done in Kenya. It is done in Lake Victoria, Turkana, Naivasha, and Baringo. Those are the main fishing grounds that we have in Kenya. It is limited, they have limited fishing that is done in the Oxbow Lakes, that is the Kanyaboli, and also we have another fishing that is limited in Shela and Birisa and also Jibe. All these ones, they are the Oxbow Lakes. We also have the Sam Reservoirs. These are the dams. They sustain fish, especially Masinga, Kabura, Kaburu, and the Kiambere. You go and get that there is the fish that is found in these dams. Then small-scale fishing is done along the rivers. That is Tana, Zoia, Hadhi, Sodu, and Nyando. Then the main fish that is gotten from all these areas that we have mentioned, the lakes, Oxbow Lakes, the reservoirs, we also have the rivers, we have the tilapia, we also have the Nile Perch, we also have Daga and herrings. So you can get, we have a number of fish in that we can get in Kenya. So you can be able to see those are the coastline, the marine fishing areas, the indented, the ones that you can be able to see, and the regular coast, you can be able to see it. For the fish ponds, you can be able to see the way they are. They are also carried out in Kenya. Let us go to the Uganda. We have the fresh water fishing. Is only type of fishing in Uganda. This is because it is a landlocked land. It is, doesn't have any outlet to the ocean or to the sea as compared to Kenya and Tanzania. Lake Victoria is the main fishing ground in Uganda, but they also have other lakes like Lake Kyoga, Lake Edward, Lake George, Lake Albert, Lake Kato. All these ones now, they are freshwater fisheries in Uganda. It is also done in rivers. Still fishing in Uganda, it is done in rivers. We have the Kagera, Semilik, Katonga, Kafu, and Nakusi. All those are rivers where they do the fishing. The main species that are caught, We have the tilapia, we have Nile Perch, we also, the two of them, then the marketing of these fish is done through the cooperative. So you can see it is more developed than Kenya. Kenya don't have the cooperatives, but when you go to the Uganda, you get that the marketing is done by the cooperatives. That is set up in processing, preservation of plants next to the fishing grounds. So you can see it is a more advanced one. Activity for today. What are the factors that have led to the freshwater fisheries in East Africa? We explain them. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book for that edition. And also, you can contact us through the SMS. You can SMS to us. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. And also, you can get us through the Twitter, where you tweet us. Stay tuned to Edin TV. Thank you.